Hello my friends, Rune here again from Oslo, Norway. And today I want to try out some more of my Umarex HDS68. I've done some mods to it, but I have not drilled it or grinded or anything. So biggest improvement was removing the small brass piece that sits in the brass tube that connects the valve to this CO2 tube. It sits in the inlet of the valve. I have a separate video of that. Shortened the valve pin, and I have when I push this, you see it won't pop off by itself. You need to push it. I have cut off the pin that goes from the latch up into the barrel bushing. And I put two O-rings in the front, one on each barrel, to help pushing the barrels rearwards. So now if I want to, I can just pull out the barrels. I don't have to disassemble the whole marker. So, but I want to just try it out a little. I have some time today to do so, so I want to do it. As always, silicone spray and Umarex brand CO2 canister. It goes outwards. Because of my shitty arthritic fingers, I will use the Allen key that comes in the box to tighten up. And the things I'm thinking about using today will be some hot glue ammo. Different weight. And I also have some rubber balls. So a good thing about this thing here compared with the HDR50 is that this thing never jams. Okay, you only have two shots, but never any jams. So, let's see how it goes. So, first off, two first drive type hot glue slugs, 120 grain. Let us see how that will go. One of the slugs seems a bit tighter than the other one. So, it's now gassed up, room temperature about 20-21 degrees Celsius, and 120 grain slug. So let's see what the power is. Didn't read. Let's try again, right barrel. .183 seems kind of low. Let's try the round ball with the lead ball inside. They weigh 114 grain. .242. Let me just straighten the box. One more with the same. Didn't read. That's the problem with the F1 Crony. It struggles to read the numbers. And ball, here's one ball, and there's the other one. next. Pure hot glue, first strike. They weigh 47 grains. So let's see if we can get some chrono number. It could be the CO2 blast that interferes with the measurement. Okay, 47 grain. 421. One more. Same type. 410. And then two hot glue round balls, nothing inside. They weigh 41 grains each. So let's see with a 41 grain ball what the velocity will be. Right barrel first. 426. 395. So it starts dropping. Let me load up a couple of black rubber balls after my last weighing measurement. They seem to come out at 57 grains, so about 3.7 gram. So let's see, rubber balls. 357. And I think I lost one. 366.
Releasing the remaining CO2.
I think the CO2 blast interfered with the readings in the chrono. So that's why I prefer to use the X-radar chrono whenever I can, because it's much more reliable when it comes to CO2 guns. So now Easter is coming, and I will be don't be shooting or anything in the Easter. So the chopper is passing. Yes, that's it for my little shooting and testing video for today. I bought it here in Norway from Game On. If you're using the coupon code RUNREBELL, you will get a 13% discount. It's fun to tinker and mess around with hot glue ammo. And but rubber balls might be more accurate. I don't know. At least more even than I can make them. But still, quite fun. So, that's it for today. Hope you liked the video. See you again another time, and thank you for watching.